Hey everyone! So in this short video, I want to show you how you can translate your Hygraph content and keep it multilingual. So I'm just going to assume that you already have a Crowdin account. It's either Crowdin Enterprise or Crowdin.com. The concepts are the very, very same. So the first thing you want to do is go to the marketplace and find a connector. We're going to go with Hygraph, so just go ahead and install that one. Now in my case, it's already installed, but for you, go ahead and install. Then you want to head back to the workspace and quickly set up a project. So let's do that real quick and I'll be right back. Amazing. So now you want to go to the integration section where you will basically set up how content from Hygraph will flow to this project. So look for Hygraph again. And now you want to click on it and you will be greeted with this pop-up. So now you'll be asked to add your credentials to enable Crowdin to connect to your Hygraph instance. Just add the project ID, the environment URL, and the permanent authentication token. Now for the permanent authentication token, just check out the marketplace guide where it'll tell you exactly which permissions have to be granted for that token. For project ID and environment, just go over to your project in Crowdin, copy the credentials, and paste them in right here. And once you've filled in all the credentials, you simply want to click on Login with Hygraph. So the next thing you see is the integration screen where it'll basically ask you to configure the connector. So let's open up the settings and do some language mapping. So for example, French in Crowdin will also be French in Hygraph. Now the other languages we're just going to skip for now. And then the next thing to set up is the display settings, meaning how each entry from Hygraph should be presented or rendered in Crowdin. Here we basically just want to select the most useful fields such as title, ID, label, etc. And then you are ready to go on. So now that our connector is ready to be used, you'll see this two-panel view. Now on the right-hand side, you'll basically see all the content and entries which are ready to be translated. So I can select those and sync them back to Crowdin. And on the left side, I will basically see all of the articles and entries that have previously been synchronized, and I'll also see the real-time progress for each language that I have in my project. I'm just gonna remove that, better. I can also at any time synchronize these translations back to Hygraph. Now, in my case, I actually have an automatic workflow so that my vendor gets notified and the translation agency knows that there is synchronized content that they can start working on. You can also choose to do this manually by creating tasks which then order the translations. Going back into the project home, let me quickly show you how the content would be presented to the translators. Now, usually the managers wouldn't look here, but I'm just going to show you anyways because I want to quickly show that Crowdin really does try to keep as much context as possible, for example, by having markdown fields so the translators always know exactly what they're working on. Moving on, let's take a look at the automatic synchronization. This will be super helpful for you if you don't want to go back and synchronize your content manually, but instead have a workflow for it. That way, you can keep your Hygraph multilingual constantly. So to do that, you want to enable these synchronizations in the settings up here. We're just going to choose once every hour for now. And what that does is basically the connector will now check for new entries every single hour, translate it, and then sync the new content automatically. And finally, let me show you how you can configure to see the translation progress in Hygraph without having to go into Crowdin at all. So for that, obviously, you want to hop into Hygraph and then click Content. And now you can see the progress of each new entry of translation over here. Super easy. So that's it for now. I really hope this video helped for a quick understanding.